He was told he invited those ones. Those ones who have got their 2 feet. Some of them have even 4. Some of them even could fly. Some of them could use any kind of means. And they could to use whatever they have. Praise be to Jesus. But when the celebration was prepared, they never came. They did not come. It is not that I've never prepared meetings for people. I have prepared meetings. If there is somebody that knows how to cook, if there is somebody who knows how to invite people to come and eat his meal, but many have never come. I have invited people to come and hear the word, but they have not come. But Jesus has told me, our time has come. I have a people for you who will never disappoint you. When you call them, they come. If I invited people here in Kirinyaga, if I had prepared a place, even they would not feel 110. They would not even feel 50
pieces.
Some of them, they would not even occupy 25
seater.
They could not even feel it. But for you, glory be to Jesus. I know if I had means to transport all of them, I believe I will not have a place for them, because I believe there are many. I believe there are many, but a time has come that we are turning around this nation, that in every place where I will go, I am going to be your voice, and your voice in this way, that whatever Jesus wants to be done for you, that is what I'm going to do, because I will not do it by my own power. I will not do it by my own strength, but I will do it in the name of our Lord. I will do everything in Jesus' name. That is why today I have an interpreter right here, and that is what will be having Pastor Monica. That church in
Kanyaga,
we must have somebody interpreting every Sunday and in every meeting, so that you know what is going on. Praise be to Jesus. We'll make sure that there is a toilet for you. You are not supposed to be sharing toilets with others, because you are special. You are special. Praise be to Jesus.
Amen.
I know you go to places there is no toilet. Praise the Lord. Now for you, you need one. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I believe in our church in Kanyaga. If there will be no other place where you can go, I believe there will be a place. Praise be to Jesus. It may not take place instantly. It may not happen instantly. But
no,
with the help of my God, something has to happen. Something has to happen. Glory be to Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because Jesus did not just come because of people who are okay. Everybody. It's only that people pretend. Everybody has a disability. Even Paul in the Bible, one of the most powerful preachers, we are not even told what kind of a disability he had. But it was a bad one. It was really bad. Can you imagine a preacher with a disability that is really bad? Because every time he kept on praying, every time he'd go on his knees, he'd be asking God, remove this thorn from my flesh. told him, my grace is sufficient for you. And today, it is only that people would not tell you. Glory be to Jesus.
Amen.
Probably your disability, we can see it. But some of us, you cannot see it. It is only that it is hidden. But everybody has a disability. Because if you are perfect, you will not be in this country. You will not be in this world. Perfect people are not on earth. They already left and departed. So a time has come for you to know you are not alone. That Jesus is in the business of turning around.
Amen.
I might not help you materially, but I have come to give you hope. I have come to give you hope. Praise it to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
One of the things that I know, that I have come to know, it is that people with the special need, they have no issue with being helped. There are people who are in between them and the help. There are people who are in between of those people and their help. But today, I want to declare that anyone or anything standing on your way,
that hindered
your blessing, anything that has hindered, that has hindered you from being what you're supposed to be, I am getting it out of your way. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Anything that has hindered, anything that has been a block on your way, we are getting it out of your way today. In the name of Jesus Christ. Glory be to Jesus. In the book of Mark chapter 1, we are told that when Jesus went into town, that people came in multitudes. And when they came in multitudes to Jesus, they were healed. Why am I telling you that the church, or me, I am to be blamed? It is because Jesus himself, when wherever he went, he was followed by people with special needs. He was in contact with them. He was in contact. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So it is your day. Because Jesus is here. If you don't want it, you are going to have Jesus. Jesus. You need him. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Your need is not your disability. Your need is Jesus. Once you have Jesus, everything will be okay. Because when you have Jesus, you have everything. Praise be to Jesus.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Because he will enable you to be in contact with the people you never have imagined.
Coming all the way from America.
Leaving my family because of
that. Family.
Glory be to Jesus. I did not come because I had the money. I came because of the love of Jesus. And because of this love, he is about to do a new thing in your life. So tell the person next to you, Jesus is doing a new thing in your life. He is transforming your life. He is transforming you. As I conclude, glory be to Jesus. As I conclude, is there someone in our meeting? You are telling me. Praise it to Jesus. Servant of God, I need that Jesus. That Jesus that will cause you to come all the way from America because of somebody with a special need. Praise the Lord. That is the Jesus that I want. Praise be to Jesus.
Amen.
Because in America,
America,
our churches are all carpeted.
Makanitha mothe makona carpet.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
But now,
no.
Jesus said,
Yesu akiuga,
you have to leave all that. Because of my beloved. The ones that I love. The ones I'm concerned about. Those are the ones I want you to go and reach. So today, I am here to declare in your life that today your life will not be the same. Somebody is talking there. You need to listen now. I want us to pray. Because this is going to be just the beginning of the great things that God is going to do. Don't look at me, please move now. If we can stop moving around, praise the Lord. Let's not be in the business of moving. Because Jesus is in the business of doing a new thing. Turn in something. Turning somebody for his glory. If we can stop the movement, if the mothers can stop, the Marthas, can we have the Marys in the house?
Marys wako wapi?
Instead of having the mothers too busy. If they can settle and we finish so that we can
finish.
If you can allow me to finish, I'll really appreciate. Let's not have any movement. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise be to Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus.
Yes.
He went into a place called Bethany.
Akiingira Bethania.
And in this place, the only place he would go
na kundu angiathire
was in the house of Simon the leper.
Athire we Simeoni.
The leper.
Ure wari na wathe.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
A man
Modo.
Where no people would visit.
Andu matangia mucereire.
Because when you had leprosy, you were supposed to be living alone with the other lepers. But now Jesus,
no Jesus,
out of all the homes in Bethany, he chose to go to the house of Simon the leper. Today, Jesus has purpose to bypass all the other homes, to bypass all the other people, and I've come to these people, and has come to you. So as every head is bowed in his presence, as we are bowing in the name of Jesus, if you're drinking, please put that cup down so that we can pray. Because if Jesus would bypass all the other homes and come to Simon the leper's home, and then in this home, he comes and sits down in a place of, in a home of someone who was rejected. A man was not supposed to be with other people. But then Simon.
No, Simeon.
Praise it to Jesus. It was his day of visitation. Just as today is your day. Your day of visitation. He was visited by the mighty God. Visited by the King of Kings. Visited by the Lord God Almighty. The Lord God Almighty is giving a visitation. Praise be to Jesus.
Amen.
And as this man gets, as Jesus gets into this house, there is a woman who was also a reject, who was known as a prostitute. She comes with a perfume in the Simon the leper. And she bows before Jesus. And she could not even eat. She was trembling in the presence of God. And she poured the oil on his feet. And she found she was not worthy. She was not even worthy. Just kneeling was not enough. But she went ahead and wiped the feet of Jesus with her hair. So what am I saying today? That Jesus allowed himself to be anointed, but this one was rejected. Yes, probably you're calling yourself a reject, because others have called you a reject. But today, Jesus, he wants your anointing. He wants your anointing. He wants your anointing. He is concerned about your anointing. It is your anointing that will make him well. It is your anointing in Kirinyaga. He has not found any other person anointed. Nobody else has the oil that is capable of anointing Jesus. The only person that can anoint him is you. I have come to give you an opportunity to anoint the King of Kings, the Lord God Almighty. I have come to give you an opportunity to anoint Jesus again. As you are anointing Jesus, you just need to come to him. I will not ask you to stand from wherever you are, but with your heart, I want you to come to Jesus with your heart today. And as you come to him, as you come to anoint him, Jesus is willing to receive you and to accept you. Even when others looked at that oil, because that is what many are asking, how can she spend a lot of money in Sifa Gardens where weddings are? Why would she pay all that money? Because of all of these people, this money could have done something else instead of bringing them to come and eat. That money should have been used to buy one of them a wheelchair. But I am here to tell you, it is because of the attraction that Jesus that you have for Jesus. He could not wait any longer until he comes you, he brings you to the meeting. He brings you to Sifa Gardens, because this is where you can anoint him by accepting him as your Lord, by opening your heart to receive him. And when every head is bowed in the presence of God, when everyone is bowed in the presence of God, I am going to ask you, are you ready to anoint Jesus? Are you ready? Because when you give your heart to Jesus, that is the only thing that can anoint him. And when he's anointed, he removes reject out of your way. You are no longer a reject, but you are now. You are now a beloved of the Lord. With the crown that you have received today, it will become a reminder that you are a child of God and sitting in the royal place with Jesus, the place of glory. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As every head is bowed in the presence of God, I'll ask you to lift up your hands if you are willing to anoint Jesus. Lift up that hand to Jesus. And if there is no hand to be lifted, Jesus is able to see, and he knows what he's going to do. But he can see your heart. He knows you came. When you are invited and you came, he knows that you even come closer and become a child of God. So when every head is bowed in the presence of God, in the presence of God, lift up that hand if you want to anoint Jesus. If you want to receive this Jesus as your Lord, in every side, even that side on on my back. So all of you, if you lift up that hand, volunteers wherever you are, you need to lift the hands that are raised in the presence of God. They are not raising those hands before man, but they are raising their hands to Jesus because they want to anoint Jesus. They don't have anything to give Jesus, but the only thing they can give him is a token of appreciation for the love that he has for them. It is lifting their hands unto him, surrendering to him and telling Jesus, I want to love you, I want to walk in your ways, I want to please you, I want to exalt you. With that hand, I can see that hand. Thank you for that hand. Thank you for that other hands. Yes, hands are raised in the presence of Jesus. All the pastors, please come. Pastors, please come. Pastors, please come. Pastors, please come. Let those hands remain lifted. Because you are here to anoint Jesus. Pastors, please join me here. Why are you afraid to come? Glory be to Jesus.
Amen.
Please don't take time. There are others lifting up their hands. There are others that are lifting up their hands. Please, pastors, go in there and pray with them. Go in there and lead them to Jesus. They want to anoint Jesus. They want to anoint the King of Kings. Continue lifting up that hand. Continue lifting up that hand unto Jesus. Lead them to Jesus. Lead them to Jesus. Please lift them to Jesus. And this time, because of those who raised their hands unto Jesus, repeat this prayer after me. Dear Lord Jesus, repeat that prayer. Dear Lord Jesus, I come to you. I know I am a sinner. But today, because you love me and prepared a feast for me, I have come. Receive me as I am. And forgive me. And have my name written in the book of life. From today, I will serve you. I will please you. This connect me now with every generation of cars. Uproot me, Jesus, from everywhere I should not be, in the name of Jesus, and plant me in your kingdom, plant me in your presence, where I will please you all the days of my life. Father, in the name of Jesus, I come before you, my God, honoring your name, thanking you for what you have done today. Thank you for those that you have saved. Thank you, Father, because they have come to anoint you. And there is celebration in heaven when one will give their life to Jesus. I want to thank you, Father, that King of glory. I did not come here for anything else, but I came, Jehovah Redeemer, so that I can have brothers and sisters that will join me in anointing you, my King. Ready to anoint Jesus. I honor your name today for each and everyone that has given their lives to you. We bless your name, King Jesus, and give you glory for what you have done. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for your presence in this place. Thank you, King of Kings, for touching lives, O God. And now at this moment, pastors, pray for all of them. Lay your hands on them. Lay your hands on each one of them. We want to declare today. Each one of them has to be prayed for. No hands on all of them. Not only one person. Lay hands on all of them. Move around, pastors. Touch them. judge them.
Because
Jesus wants us just to lay hands on them. And things will not be the same. Things will be different. Lay hands on all of them.
Father,
in the name of Jesus, we declare a special anointing upon these dear ones. And in the name of Jesus, we declare a special anointing that is going to rest upon each one of them. Thank you for your power. Thank you for your anointing. Thank you for touching them. Thank you for turning their lives around. Thank you for filling them with your power. Thank you for setting them apart. Thank you, Jesus, because that is what you did. Everyone that came to you, my Father, you touched them and healed them. Those who were bound, Jehovah, they were delivered. And today, Jehovah, you speak the anointing of God upon this one, my Father. Jesus. We thank you, Father.
We
and we give you glory. We honor you and lift you up. And declare that there is no one like you. As we give a child's offering unto the King of Kings, as we tell him, thank you, Lord. As we lift up our voices, let us celebrate before him.